Mr. Patel, just coming on that point, India has a lot of potential, but we do need, you know, just taking away from the earlier panel where the CEA spoke about an ecosystem to encourage R&D, universities and, you know, expenditure coming in from the government to encourage research, which might not always culminate into results. Is this the kind of vision that we have need to have for the Indian market in order to encourage biologics, encourage innovative patented drugs coming in?
So I think any industry to grow requires a proper ecosystem. And the ecosystem, not only for existing industry, but particularly in the industry where we are in pharma, innovation becomes a very integral part of the business, because we are in the business of science. What we need really is a good India innovation policy. I think we need to think how India will ride the innovation wave. I believe Indians have capability to innovate. The question is whether there is an environment conducive around to make that happen. Do we want to really get into a lot of administrative and bureaucratic hurdles in doing research? Or do we really want to encourage research and give free hand to research to do things? The future lies in biologics. And one of the biggest challenges is every biologics in India is very tightly controlled by several ministries and have several issues around that. One need to really think, if you really want biological research to come up, we don't need so many ministries to control it, be it Department of Biotechnology, be it Pharmaceutical Ministry, be it Drug Control Department, and be it the Environment Ministry. No other research is controlled in any country like this, what is happening here. So we need to really think, we need a strong innovation policy if we want to see the Indian research to really rise up. We have done great in terms of developing products which are generic, similar to the best in the world. Question is now, we have to go beyond this with specialty drugs and followed by new drugs. And if that is to happen, India needs to have a conducive innovation policy.
Mr. Mehta, do you think that we've probably missed the bus when we compare ourselves to, say, China, which is really, you know, has a vision when it comes to healthcare by, say, I think 2025, and we've already seen the kind of biosimilars and the innovation which has come out from China. Do you think that we've probably missed the bus? We're a little too late when it comes to this kind of innovation policy that we need.
I don't think it's missing the bus. We as Indian Pharma had our priorities over the last 10 years, and we've been busy with what we thought were our key goals were. We've done reasonably well on that. As what Pankaj Bhai said, that what takes us into the next league, from a pure generic play to more differentiated products to eventually to the innovation, science-driven business, that is two aspects. One, what he elaborated was what the government policy ought to be, which encourages that. We have not one which is in place. So, so that's an important missing link. I guess the other major issue is that a lot of fundamental research work has happened out of the world-class universities, which is what the US has and what China has recently invested a lot in. I think India is nowhere close to that. So, so that's another important area of work that would eventually have to happen. Whether as an industry, have we lost an edge? I don't think that there are any significant disadvantage we have on that account. I mean, we are trying to tackle the situation, each one of us in our own ways, working through collaborative arrangements with other organizations. And eventually, I am sure that Indian pharma would cope with the challenge. But these are some of the more fundamental issues that at some point in time at the government level will have to be probably addressed. And that would give the industry a greater and a stronger position in the years to come.
Can I just add something to that? Because I have a slightly different point of view than that. Because I think, see, the question you also asked was, one was on the ecosystem, and also, you know, have you missed the bus? Right, so on the second part of it, we haven't missed the bus, because like Mr. Patel said in the beginning that, you know, we have the proven capabilities to discover drugs. So that's not a question. But I think we're losing the plot, right? So I think that's a bigger concern, because you also said, you know, what's happening in China. So Mr. Francia, who is there, he can add to that. You're talking about a company, for example, just last month, mm-hmm. right, called Bigene, mm-hmm. right, which is a company. It has got a product, put up for approval in the U.S., which mm-hmm. is classified under the breakthrough designation, mm-hmm. right? So this is not something for China. It's actually for the world market. So it's a breakthrough designation they've got from the FDA. So if it gets approved, you can see where it's going. Mm-hmm. One. If September last year, if I remember, in China, another company called, I forget the exact name, but Chimed or something like that. There's a company which had a product, which got approval in China to be launched as a new discovery in the field of immuno-oncology, which is the important thing, because mm-hmm. they've had molecules before. India also has molecules which have been launched, but, in the field of immuno-oncology. So if you see these two things, these two events, in terms of what's happening from China in when it comes to an ecosystem, the government involvement, the VC funding, and also the industry and academia kind of a collaboration, it is far, far ahead of India. And that's mm-hmm. the reality we have to face, because we had all these opportunities in the past, and I think we are somewhere losing the plot, because I don't think we have a policy which puts everything together. Mm-hmm. Right? So, somebody has to take the lead in the government to say that this is the vision for the industry. Because frankly, if you ask me, we don't have a choice, mm-hmm. because we can't continue to survive on this generics game. Sure. We need to move beyond that, because it's not just specialty or biosimilars. Ultimately, the holy grail is innovation.
Right.
So, and we shouldn't miss the bus.
Yes.
So that's the key thing.
Absolutely. But Mr. Vaidheesh, what do you think, what would you want from the government? Say you have to pick out three things in order to encourage this kind of innovation that we need from India. What would you suggest to the government? Mr. Patel mentioned that, an innovation policy. What would your thoughts be?
I can speak on the innovation. Before that, I think it's very important, fundamental thing that we need to fix it. But I know it can take a little more number of years to happen. But nevertheless, I think we need to make the point. As long as in India, 65% of the people are going to pay out of pocket, mm-hmm. I think we have a problem in hand. So if a compromised human being is going to buy a medicine who has got only 10 rupees, and there are people who are going to give medicines worth 10, whether it's optimal or suboptimal. Mm-hmm. So in my opinion, fundamentally, we have a flawed system of people having to pay out of pocket. Nowhere else, 65% of the healthcare expenditure is paid out of pocket. So that makes it very harder for this whole market ecosystem to work. Okay? Mm-hmm. So fundamentally, a few recommendations which I have been talking about it for quite a number of years, which I worked on, is we need to make sure the health insurance, or what I call the financial models, have to fall in place. We need to promote new innovative financing model for people to consume healthcare and medicines. Second, I even talked about healthcare savings account should be promoted in this country so that people can use that to buy their healthcare. But otherwise, what will happen is that we'll end up in using price control as the only mechanism of affordable medicine, which in my opinion is the minimal thing that you are doing in the country, where you are not encouraging good healthcare. Mm. So keeping that in context, the day when we move away from a comprehensive new finance model, leveraging the power of billion, where everybody has an access, people are going to find financial access, people are going to ask for a good quality healthcare. As an example, today, Ayushman Bharat, a common man has got a 5 lakhs, he or she is going to go and tell a hospital saying that I need the best care. Mm-hmm. So what is likely to happen is that the people are going to say, now somebody has got a money to pay for it, demand support with finance, will promote a good quality healthcare. Now, if that happens, then the innovation will start coming in. Mm-hmm. Now, innovation, right now, the concept people here talk about is the frugal innovation. Innovation means, how do I come up with an app to make sure consumers are able to go and get products at a cheaper price. Mm-hmm. Now, in my opinion, these are all not real innovation. Second innovation, drug discovery innovation. As many of them have said, you definitely need a good ecosystem which supports. Like, for example, Telangana has got a fantastic approach to innovation. I think we need to really applaud Telangana government for driving such approach to drug discovery and digital innovation. We have to go a long way. We need to create an excitement, innovation around for innovation, because even right now I'm putting a manufacturing facility of 1,000 crores. I'm even wondering what is the viability of the 1,000 crore because the policies have changed so much. Mm-hmm. So if I am going to invest 1,000 crore innovation, there has to be so much of clarity on the policy which will help us to say, okay, I'm willing to syndicate the risk. Okay, who's going to syndicate the risk with me? Then the innovation can happen. So I think it's a big subject, but as far as I'm concerned, I think we have the right talent pool. We have that everything is right, it's just that it's not working out in tandem mm-hmm. to make sure it happens.
Mr. Reddy, are you worried about growth? Because should the industry be worried about growth? Because on one end, we have the US markets where there is more genericization taking place every day. India, there is lack of policy stability. So is there a view that maybe growth is probably getting impacted in the pharmaceutical space? We're probably going to see a slowdown. We need to see other avenues of growth. And if so, where is it coming from?
No, I don't think there's going to be a problem with growth, because in the spaces that we are in at this point of time, there's plenty of opportunity.
Which are those spaces?
So if I take it one by one, right? So if you look at the API itself, mm-hmm. right? So there is a problem, like Vaidish highlighted in the beginning, saying that those prices have gone up. Right, mm-hmm. So it's also an opportunity for India mm-hmm. to actually restart the production, and then some interventions are required for that. But by and large, you're seeing most of the companies revive their business on the intermediates as well as the API front. Right, so you're seeing that. So that's a short-term opportunity, and if they become competitive, and if things fall into place, I think that's a good space to be in. That's number one. If you see on the generics itself, right? Of course, this whole price deflation and the customer consolidation has actually affected most of the companies in the last, say, a couple of years, or even slightly longer than that. But then I think the way things are now shaping up, because there's a little bit of stabilization of that on one hand, and also, some of the opportunities coming in because the top companies are beginning to vacate that space,
mm-hmm.
right? And talk more overseas yeah. companies doing that. And then that's giving an opportunity for Indian companies to take that space. So you're seeing that. And then you're seeing biosimilars. It's still a story, still unfolding. And you're seeing more and more companies into it, getting into other markets, emerging markets, as well as the Western markets. US will take time. But you're seeing these other markets also opening up. So from all this, I think there's plenty of growth opportunity, all in the short to medium terms. Anyway, it's there, right? So I was more especially referring to the innovation part of it, because that's going to drive the ultimate growth.
Yes.
Long term, you really have to do something about it. Otherwise, we'll be nowhere in the global space, and especially when we compare to China. That would be my...
Well, I'm getting the signal to wrap up the panel. Thank you very much for joining in this evening and taking us through all of your thoughts. Thank you very much.
Thank you.